I asked Phil Edwardson to help me and, you know, come up with me to offer me moral support, but he wouldn't do the last mile with me, so I guess not. Okay, I'll just remember. And part of my background takes in a very long range of years. In other words, I've been in music forever. And I'm not about to give up unless my health gives up before I do. But anyway, to start this evening's program with a couple of things that have to do with my roots, and so that some of you young people might not be familiar with, but I think someone else in your family might. This is one that we did about 1947, and it featured the guys in the saxophone section. And it's an old Jimmy Giuffre tune called The Four Brothers. Since gone on to become one of the truly great orchestrators for motion pictures, television, and the Broadway theater. And 2 years ago, he won an Oscar for his great orchestrations for the film musical Cabaret. And here's one he wrote as a member of our band. It's called Early Autumn.
Thank you.
Neil Kirkland, trombone. Do one from an album that we had last year that we were very fortunate with. It won a Grammy Award for being supposedly the outstanding big band jazz album of 1973. And the title of the album is Giant Steps, and the tune I'd like to do for you, I think, is a very exciting one, written by Chick Corea, and it's called La Fiesta.
Thank you.
Tiberi, tenor. Sal Spicola, piccolo. Dennis Dotson, flute. Jim Pugh. And I'd like for him to do a tune that's included in an album that this year won a Grammy Award for us, an album titled The Thundering Herd. And this is a lovely Michel Legrand tune that's been around for a few years. Here's Jimmy Pugh playing What Are You Doing the Rest of Your Life? the ranches, one of the charts that we have this past year made available for the stage bands in high schools and the lab bands in colleges. And it's through the marvelous cooperation of the Hal Leonard Publishing Company, which is one of the foremost, if not the foremost, publisher of educational kind of music. And they have a jazz department now, and we're involved in that. And one of the tunes that we did in the arrangement I'd like to do for you is a Bill Stapleton chart, and it's a Carole King tune called Corazon. Thank you.
Thank you.
deserves. Half the album is done with the Houston Symphony. It's music written for our band and orchestra by a young man who's been writing for our band for the past 5 years. His name is Alan Broadbent. He's a young New Zealander who's now pushing 28. He's got a little way to go. But anyway, half the album is made up of this music. The title of the album is simply The Children of Lima, which is one of the pieces written for our band and orchestra, and also a suite in four sections for movements called Variations on a Scene. On the other side, these are more of Alan's arrangements, and one of them includes this lovely tune, which has been around for a couple, 3 years, a thing called Where is the Love? And we can actually do it instrumentally, and it shows the versatility of Frank here on this thing. It's kind of a hall tree made into a lovely thing. It's like, you know what it is. And this one, Sal plays this, which is kind of a heavier type flute, bigger. Maybe with these two heavy cats now.
Thank you.
to and do a tune that I had the good fortune of introducing on records in 1900, and I thought I'd just do a little bit of it to see if there's anyone here that might bring back the memory of someone. It actually was a good omen and a good thing for me a lot of years ago, because it was one of two times when we won a gold record. And a gold record, as you probably, I'm sure, know, has to do with the sale of a record or an album. If it sells in the neighborhood of a million, then you receive a gold record award. It has nothing to do, however, with the quality of the record. Could be a real turkey. This, fortunately, was a lovely tune. It's just that somebody else should have done it. In those days, you did what they told you to do, pretty much, up to a point. There was a, for instance, in a newspaper just the other night, I think it was in Washington, there was a critique about our performance there. The young man, or not so young man, who did the, was a critic and wrote the review of our performance, merely stated that this is a tune that I did many years ago, and that it was a great deal to be desired about the sound of my voice in the performance of this tune. However, he said his phrasing was very good. So if you would please now just listen to my phrasing and forget the voice, we can reach some kind of point of compatibility here. But it really is a great old tune, and if you'll forgive me, I don't even care if you don't forgive me. I don't care. Close eyes.
Thank you. Thank you.
cutting power of the trumpet.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've certainly been a lovely group, and we've enjoyed playing for you. We'd like to thank the members of the Key Club for inviting us. I hope sometime we can all get together again.